सो हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द स्टैट्स मॉडल ट्यूटोरियल। सो एज यू सॉ इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट, व्हाट वी डिड नो रिग्रेशन विद द हेल्प ऑफ स्टैट्स मॉडल, व्हिच वी यूज्ड टू प्रीवियसली डू विद द हेल्प ऑफ साइकिटल एंड पाइथन लाइब्रेरी। And then we plotted some regression graphs too also, and then we loaded the data set and we checked and we saw their attributes too. So these were something that we did in the first video. So in this video we'll move ahead and plot some more regression data sets, and that will come our way, right? So okay, so first of all, let's just matplotlib line. So I'm gonna just import all the necessary packages, right? You can see. So so this time I'm using the dataset which is Duncan's Prestige dataset. So you know, we can also use a utility function to load any dataset available from the packages. Right now I'm using it this way, so I'm gonna just run it. So if you want to see what sort of data it is, so you have the type, you have the income, you have the education, right? Again, if you want to let me just okay, so here we go. Oh my bad, I was trying to just yeah. So here you have it. So now if you want to check the shape, you can again do that. So you got 45 rows and 4 columns. So again, I'll just move ahead. So you are able to visualize the data. So now I'll just load our OLS model. So first we'll go for the OLS and then we'll see for WS2. So I'll just bring the model summary. So here you have it, the summary of our model. You have the number of observation, date, time. So it's very interesting. You know, you can see the date at which we are doing this. It's also showing that. So now we'll just move ahead. So influence plots. So influence plots, show the studentized residual versus the leverage of each observation as measured by the hat matrix. So, externally, studentized residuals are a residual that are scaled by their standard deviation, right? So, I won't go into much, depth about those mathematical concepts. Again, I would recommend you to go ahead and check some concepts by yourself from statsmodel.org, because again, when you talk about machine learning, you really need to have a good grasp of the concepts, mean, various deviation, standard deviation and all. So I'm gonna just print the influence plot. So here you have it. So as you can see, there are a few worrisome observations. Both the contractor and reporter have low leverage but a large residual, as you can see by the shape of their circle. So engineer RN engineer has small residual and large leverage. Conductor and minister have both high leverage and large residuals, and therefore obviously means larger influence. So what we see from the influence plot is that how much influence the individual occupation, I should say, has on the data set. So more the size of their circle, that means more influence they have, right? So since we are doing a multivariate regression, as you can already see, we cannot just look at the individual bivariate plots to discern relationship. So instead, what we are going to do, so we want to look at the relationship of the dependent variable and independent variables conditionally on the other independent variables. So we can do this through using partial regression plots, otherwise known as variable plots. So let me just go ahead and we'll have a problem. So when you see the notable points of this plot are that the fitted line has slope beta k, if you remember beta k from our cycle line discussion, and intercept 0. So the residual of this plot are the same as those of the least square fit of the original model with full x, that is our independent variable. So you can discern the effects of individual data values on the estimation of a coefficient easily, right? You can also see the violation of underlying assumptions such as linearity. No, obviously there isn't that much of a linearity we exactly are seeing now. Again, I want to go ahead and do for this. So again, you have this, right? So as you can see, the partial regression plot confirms the influence of conductor, minister and RR. As you can see, RR engineer on the partial relationship between income and prestige. So the cases greatly decrease the effect of income on prestige. So dropping these cases will confirm this definitely. So that's what you are going to do next. So you drop the cases, so you just take a quick check on all the regress. You can use the plot part regress grid. So these plots will not be able to label the points, but you can use them to identify a problem and then use plot part regress to get more information. Again, I would recommend you to try by yourself. This is what I am saying, right? So let me just do it for once and you can try it. So here you have it, right? So as I already said, they will not label the points, but you can use them to identify the problem that you are facing in your algorithm. And so this part plot part regress grid. Let me just comment it out so that plot part. Great. So you can use this plot to get more information, right? So for now we'll just move ahead with our discussion. So as you can see the relationship so let me just first of all, yeah. So the have, as you can see, I have plotted the component and component plus residual plot. So as you can see, the relationship between the variation in prestige explained by the education conditional on the income seems to be linear, as you can see. Though you can see there are some observations that are exerting considerable influence on the relationship. So we can quickly look at one more variable by using the function plot CCPR grid. So the CCPR plot I briefly mentioned. So the CCPR, which stands for component plus residual. CCPR plot provides a way to judge the effect of one regressor on the response variable by taking into account the effects of other independent variable. Right. So let me just do it for another variable. Right. Here you have it. So that is a residual for income and education. right? So again, so yeah. So now will you plot regress exorg. So the plot regress exorg function is a convenience function, you know, that will give you a 2x2 plot containing the dependent variable and fitted values with confidence interval versus the independent variable chosen. So the residuals of the model versus the chosen independent variable are sort of a partial regression plot basically, and a CCPR plot. So this function can be usually used for, you know, quickly checking model assumptions with respect to signal regressor. So just so as you can see, okay, so now we'll move ahead and we'll use a fit plot. So the plot fit function plots a fitted value versus a chosen independent variable. It includes prediction confidence interval and optionally plots the true dependent variable. So we can see for cell, there we have it, right? So yeah, so okay, okay, so we'll just you know, do one more data set. That is so right now I'm loading a state crime data set. It's a 2009 crime data set from UCLA study. You can go ahead and look at it. So let me just load it first. Oh my bad, just first this. So you can see murder, urban plus poverty plus HS grade plus single. So you can, you know, see those stats for yourself. Now if I want to regression, partial regression, here you have it. So you know, you can see for yourself how much, you know, the crime rate is in you know, in comparison to the poverty, urbanization, or if the you know, person is single or not, right? So just move ahead, and so this is the major cities in the United States where we are checking. So this is the partial regression plot, right? So let me just do, and we'll do our leverage residual. So here you have it. So this is sort of, you know, related to the influence plot on the leverage residue 2 plot, right? Now suppose you want to print the influence, see the, so here you have it. So as you can see, District of Columbia has a big influence in comparison to Mississippi or Illinois. Right, so now again, you know, training any or you know, in process of building any learning algorithm, main aim is to obviously, you know, correct our outliers. So right now we are gonna do that. So you know, because you know, the part of the problem here in this model is kind of recreating the state result that M estimators are not robust to leverage points. Again, there should be better examples. So we are gonna just do a robust regression to correct the outliers. Here we go. Now I'm gonna, again using the same data set. So again, so here you have it, your you know, we tried. So as you can see, we doesn't have much, those many outliers that we were having earlier. As you can see, only we have one outliers. Now suppose If you want to, you know, print, you can have that tool. So let me just do that for you. So, you know, always when talking about analysis and building model, you should always has a full, you know, I should say vivid view of what exactly your model looks like. So that's why I would always recommend you to go ahead and, you know, have a look at how things are, you know, when you see a model in a way that you on the basis of which you make your learning algorithm, right? So let me just metro. Norms. So this is sort of a, you know, influence plot that I'm going to print right now, right? So here we have it. So let me just fit it. So now just print it. Okay, so there's an error on this error. Okay, let me just check it. We have made some mistake. PCT metro plus poverty plus PTCS plus single data is equal to DAM is equal to robust. Okay, fit. Okay, let me see. Error validating the name error name is not defined. Okay, I think let's just go without this because I think we have to. Okay. Alright, I think. Okay, all right. Oh, okay. Yeah, I got that. So basically, guys, let me just comment it out. So what you have to actually do, you have to run this before you apply this, you know, command, because obviously our aim was to, you know, look weird of what we are trying to do. So you had to, you know, do it before that. So again, I am doing that to you, right? You should definitely go ahead and do that yourself. So what you need to do, so this was basically what exactly we were trying. So the point was, you know, if the model instance has been used for another fit with different parameters, so then the fit options, you know, might not be correct ones anymore. So that's the problem why we are not able to, you know, run, because as you can see earlier we have chosen another, right? So So you know, there is only one way which through which you can you know, use your model instance for fitting your algorithm. Okay, so let me just, yeah. So guys, I think so you know, here as you can see, we learned more about regression, you know, by the way, of stats model. So the main reason we went for regression was because, you know, it's sort of a base through which you can, you know, you can learn more about stats model, Python library. Again, I would recommend you to go ahead, check out more examples of stats model from the statsmodel.org, where there you can learn a lot of things about you know, stats model library, and which will eventually help you in making your algorithm and more efficient, right? So guys, that's it for this video.